out of your energy drink?
Whoops. Okay, hey, everybody. Today's a special day. I'm actually not working on Songbringer today. I'm working on RapidGame. This is actually something I use with Songbringer, the video game. This is Songbringer's image. RapidGame is a tool for pre-building cocos2d-x, and cocos2d-x just came out with a new version, 3.7. So I'm going to upgrade RapidGame and make it work with this new version, and a lot has changed with this new version of cocos2d-x. They've actually merged cocos2d-x and cocos2d-js into the exact same download. 3.7 is now, there's no more cocos2d-js. Basically, it's all cocos2d-x, which means they're basically just throwing all their JavaScript bindings and the SpiderMonkey engine into cocos2d-x, the download, making them one. So it confuses people less, which is really awesome. It's much clearer. You just need cocos2d-x now. It's a really good move, I think. So I want to check one thing. GitHub has cocos release. Where is it? It's I want to check their. Hey, what's up, Lith? What's up? I'm doing some weird stuff today. I'm not actually working on Songbringer. I'm working on RapidGame, upgrading it today. So this is mostly code day, and that's it. I'm looking for their release notes because I know a lot has changed in cocos2d-x 3.7. This is releases. I want release notes. Maybe it's right here in the root. We'll see. Read me, changelog. Maybe it's changelog. Yeah, what's up? How you doing, Lith, man? What you working on? What you doing today? What's up, Ethan? Here's some of the stuff that's changed in cocos2d-x 3.7. This is why I'm doing this right now. All of these fixes and stuff, I'd really like to incorporate all these fixes into Songbringer. So I really want to upgrade RapidGame and also get it working with the new format of JS being merged with X. Let's see if they mention anything about auto batching. Looks like they fixed one tiny thing related to, that was in 3.3. No, they haven't fixed batching, I don't think. Cool, good for you, Ethan. Okay, I'm just gonna dive right into this rather than messing too much with checking out their release notes and all that. So I got some instructions to myself. I wrote these a while ago of like how to upgrade RapidGame because it's always, you know, a few months between times that I actually do this. So I don't think I've gotten any current edits. Nice, you made 4 cents. Really, way to go. That's awesome. It reminds me of the movie Jack Black's in when he plays his guitar and earns some money. You're teaching yourself C++? Nice. Cool. Good for you, man. Good for you. Awesome. What do you want to do with your C++? Yeah, no changes. Okay, so first instruction is basically to move the old cocos2d.js folder out, move the new one in. Everything's gonna change, everything's gonna break because they changed the whole path structure of cocos2d.x. So that's gonna be the hard part of this, is redoing all of the path structures for RapidGame, which is probably gonna be a bitch, basically. But I'm gonna start diving in. to this. So, I used to have source cocos2d-js. This is now going to be source cocos2d-x. And then everything's going to change. So, yeah, Ethan, it takes a long time to get people to start donating to you and your projects. So that's why I'm always encouraging you to keep going, keep making games and doing what you love. You know, I would say it would take at least 3 months before anyone's going to trust you enough and see that you've worked enough that they're going to want to donate to you, you know? And you know, if you have a game that they want to play, then of course they're going to purchase that if they want, if they really like it. So that's one way to earn money too. Okay, here's the old one. Move it out. I'm going to go get a fresh... No, I'm just going to get this build, right, this cocos2d-x right here. Throw it in. How you delete a panel? I think you just delete it, man. There's a little delete button. Twitch. Wizard. No, that was not it. Twitch. Yeah, you see this, Ethan? There's just a remove button on every one of the panels. Super easy, man. You can do it. Edit panels, right? You click edit panels and you just click remove. Yes. Nice. Cool, man. Good for you. That's awesome. Electrical engineering. That's a cool combo there. Electrical engineering and C++. You can probably do a lot with that. Okay, I've got the new folder in. The next thing I want to do is remove all the samples, docs, templates, and stuff that I'm not going to need to check in to wrap a game, basically. So, CMake, let's show the size for everything in this folder. Basically, I want to remove stuff that's going to be really big and just keep all the source code for cocos2d-x, but throw away the stuff that's not going to be needed. Do you have any panels yet? Gladiar, what's up, man? Yeah, I'm streaming really late today. It's been a kind of a weird day for me for as far as timing goes, you know? So I'm trying to do one stream at least today. So my apologies. Okay, so we don't need the docs folder. Keep CMake. Extensions. Yeah, keep that. External, all of these are needed, especially Spider Monkey, which is huge. 126 megs of the cocos2d-x download is just Spider Monkey. Curl's huge too. These are all libraries for, like, you know, all the platforms that cocos2d-x supports. That's why it's such a big download. Plugin, we might not need this. Oh, we do. We need the JS bindings. Whoa, they moved those to here. The plugin directory. Ethan, did you click the edit button? Cool. Nice, man. Electrical engineering. I went to the Oregon Institute of Technology. It's in Oregon. And yeah, a lot of my friends were electrical engineers and they always had the coolest projects and stuff. But I was really into software then, so I didn't really learn that much about hardware or electrical, but I'm very curious about it now. Now that I'm a little older, I'm really, really curious about stuff. Yeah, we don't need the templates. We don't need the tests. We don't even need any of these tools. We don't need the bindings. Yeah, we don't need any of this stuff. The one thing that's... no, we don't need it. Web, yeah, we need that. Oh, crazy. Yeah, I don't know, Ethan. I don't know, man. A Okay, so we've got this. This is where stuff's gonna get really weird. I'm gonna just create a new branch, probably. Let's do this. Would remove any Git modules. Actually, let's find any Git modules. Here. Before I delete them, I'm gonna find them, show what we have. Okay, so there's one Git modules folder or Git modules file. Console, plugin, bindings. Yeah, delete all these. Okay, next thing. This is where I'm getting nervous. Get at all and commit, because this is where I'm committing myself to this whole upgrade process. This could take a long time to fix and stuff, but maybe I should do a new branch. Nah, screw it. Okay, get at all, commit. Wow. Yeah. Yeah, that's really smart. That's a really, really smart decision. I like that. So true, right? You'd really do need a lot of help with hardware. But software, it's today we have so much stuff online that you can basically learn software on your own. So I totally agree. Parker boy, yes, I have definitely used Linux plenty. I love Linux. In fact, my favorite distro right now is Debian. I use Debian quite often, actually. I have a server and it runs Debian. I've also run Slackware in the past. This was like back in early 2000s. I was getting into Linux and stuff. So yeah, man, I love Linux. I love Unix. That's why I love OS X so much, is because it has Unix. So really what I love the most is the Unix part of it all. So yeah, I'm good, Ethan. Okay, next step. Commit. So what I'm gonna do here is check and see everything. So this is gonna be huge, 'cause it's doing new, this is all new files. Right, yeah, totally, it's physical. You know what's so cool about setting hardware now is we're having this whole maker revolution type thing where everybody's starting to make little robots and devices and drones and inventions and stuff like that. So you learning hardware right now is actually really, really apropos. You're gonna be able to use that basically. You're gonna be able to either make money doing it or do what you love doing it or invent stuff doing it. I totally think it's a good idea. Okay, do I really need to do this? Really, what I wanted to see was, let's do Shift G and get to the end. New file, new file, new file. So let's look for. Got a couple of JS solutions. Okay. Well, that's kind of scary, man. I don't know what to do there. It should have removed the old JS folder. That's what I'm looking for here. Oh, I never even checked this all in. That's right. Oh, screw this. This is not the upgrade process. This is the old upgrade process. Okay. Anyways, yeah, quit this. Wait, so how do I undo adding? I forget how to do that. How do I do this? Yeah, I haven't committed. Yeah, git reset. Cool. All right. Yay. Back to nothing changed. Okay. I forgot that those weren't even checked in. So, okay. The patch, though, this is the crazy part. I want to apply this patch to the existing folder. Okay, huh. Yeah, totally, right? Be unique. Do something new. I would say do what you love. Follow your passion, you know, because that's what's helped me so much with this video game, Songbringer, is just doing what I love so much. And I wanted to do this game so bad, but I had doubts. I had doubts that I wouldn't make me any money because I have never really made money making games because I never really marketed them that well. So the point was that I doubted myself, that I doubted that I would even be able to successfully make Songbringer. But when I finally started just believing in myself and just making the video game, it all started happening. You know, it was a risk, and I took the risk and it worked. And that's why I encourage other people to take that risk too and just do what you love. All right. So I'm going to open up this patch and see if I can do what's necessary to apply this patch to the new cocos2d-x, which is going to be crazy because I don't know if any of this is going to work, but we'll see. So let me look for cocos2d-x props. Cool, there it is. There's the props. All right, I'm gonna open this up. With TextMate. There we go. Okay, so the patch is to remove LiveBox2D and LiveSpine. From the cocos2d props because they always mess up the build. And I'm gonna keep the last semicolon here. What these do is they mess up the build when you're building from the command line. And even though I submitted a bug fix to the cocos2dx team, they basically just said that they didn't like it basically. Yes, exactly. Yeah, if you already know that, dude, you're well on your way to an enjoyable life. Let's hope the render is in the same place. Cool, it is. All right. I'm going to go and manually apply more of this patch. This is part of the patch which creates the ability to set a float array. What's up, Felix DJ? Felix Dej? Yeah, it's a really, really late stream for me, right? I normally never, ever start this late. But yeah, it's been a weird timing for me today. But I still wanted to get at least a stream in. I'm doing a weird thing. I'm not working on Songbringer. I'm indirectly working on Songbringer, actually. I'm working on the underlying game engine behind Songbringer today, RapidGame. Actually, cocos2d-x, RapidGame just builds cocos2d-x faster. I mean, it builds it once, so you never have to build it again. Actually, that's what it does. Okay, so we got GL floats. This is inside uniform apply GL float. We're gonna remove that, and if it's this type, it does that. That type, it does that. So let's make sure this is still looking about how it was. Yes, set uniform location with 1FV, 1F, right. Uniform location value float V dot pointer. Okay, they changed how stuff works. Okay, well, what? Nice, thank you. Thanks, Ladiar. All right, man, this means I'm gonna have to go and actually open up the cocos2d-x project and do this in there. Yeah, okay. I'll save this. Close that. And I'm gonna open up cocos2d-x and open up their build for lives. Yeah, I want lives. Okay. Cocos2d lives. And this is probably gonna be in their 2D renderer folder, or maybe it's just renderer. Yeah, it's in render. Awesome, Ethan. Okay, so we got renderer, and the file I'm looking for is GL program state. I think it's just GL program state. And check that. Yeah, GL program state. Okay, so now I can actually go in and, like, you know, jump to functions and stuff. First thing I should do is actually edit the header, give it the files it needs so it's not complaining about these missing variables and stuff. First thing is the int array count. This is inside I think it's inside is this it? This is around line 76. Okay, that's probably not it. I don't think it was vertex attrib value anyways. It was more like, yeah, uniform value. Yeah, it's uniform value. Okay, so we've got array count. It's got a union of all these different kind of values. Oh, did they actually fix this finally? Did they finally give it, like, making float array floats so you can Yes, oh, they finally did. They made Uniforms, so you can set an array. Oh, I don't even need to do any of these changes. Sweet. Yay, cocos2d-x. This is something awesome. So cool. Okay, so program state. Let's get rid of that. That. All this stuff. Okay, cool. Ethan, how do you make graphics? That's a long, long answer right there, but you start with the program like Photoshop and you just use pens and brushes and stuff to draw. Okay, so the next thing, if I weren't to do that, which is one of the most important parts of it all, actually, that's all there is. Okay, cool. Oh, man, that's all there is to the patch, which is sweet. So now I'm going to go create a new patch. Got some instructions on how to do it here. Okay. There should be only be changed one file, so this is kind of stuck, so I don't have to do this whole thing like this. But anyways, copy-r source. No, code. I call it code. Why did I? RapidGame source cocos2d-x. Copy it to here. Ethan, there's plenty of other programs you can use besides Photoshop. There's GIMP, for example. You should do a tutorial, man. Do a tutorial on how to make graphics for games. How about this? There you go, Ethan. Nice. Okay, got that copied. Oh shoot, I did this wrong. Damn it. Okay, all I'm trying to do right now is create a diff file. Yeah, Felix, cocos2d-x has the concept of a scene. It's the type of class which the director can run, and it pushes, it's exactly like you said, it just pushes them on and off. Let me show you an example. It's in, like, right here in the beginning of Songbringer. It starts the game. It runs the initial app. It goes and it creates the first scene. And that is, like, right here. It just runs the scene. And all it does is call create method on, like, overworld scene, for example. Overworld scene is a scene where it displays the current overworld, and all it does is it creates a new scene, initializes it, auto-releases it, returns it. And then this kit run scene method, all it does is it calls the director, it gets the director, checks that if it already has a running scene, it pushes it on, basically, by calling run with scene. This essentially is a push. Or there's replace scene if you're replacing the current scene. So yeah, in answer to your question, yes, it's just pushing and popping scenes. Come on, copy it right. Yeah, you're welcome, man. Sorry, guys. Sometimes I get really frustrated when I'm upgrading Rapid Game. Because they change stuff so much. Every time they release a new version of cocos2d-x, they change everything. And then it gets really frustrating to upgrade this whole tool that all it does is it just compiles cocos2d-x for you, it makes it faster. Right? Yeah. But it depends on your project, you know, if you're really into it, then it's never gonna be boring. Okay, here. All right, so next is, so what I'm doing here is I'm creating a whole Git repository to check the differences. This is how I can accurately track what has changed. And then I go and I create a patch file so that when what RapidGame does is it goes and automatically downloads cocos2d-x for you. And then it applies a patch file if it needs to change anything, which there are almost always a few things it needs to change. So this is my way of creating a patch file. I basically just initialize a Git repository, copy over the changed cocos2d-x, compare it to the unchanged cocos2d-x, and then create a patch file based on that. So that's what I'm doing right now. Yes, totally right. School can sometimes be so boring, right? Type of projects, super important. Oh, I told you this wrong. I'm supposed to copy the latest version. Oh man. Today. Okay, well I wanna go to downloads, cocos2d-x 3.7. Start this over. Yes, yeah, right. Yeah, progress is such a good thing, right? To see, to feel in a project, especially long-term projects like making video games or anything where you're creating something for a long time. Yeah, progress is almost essential. That's why sometimes when I'm making my winking games, or especially, you know, yeah, whenever I'm making games, sometimes I'll go and stop a current task I'm working. If a current task takes like more than a week, I'll be like for example, the overworld. I've spent more than a week working on the overworld, and I really don't have that much to show for it yet as far as a playable game. So tomorrow, that's why today I'm actually doing this rapid game upgrade, but tomorrow I might actually just start with something else. Something that I can immediately see the results from and feel that sense of progress, you know? So I'm just doing this again. I'm repeating the process because I did it wrong. I was supposed to first copy the unchanged version of cocos2d-x. That's what I'm doing. I did there. Now I init a new repository. Add everything. I guess that's another benefit to doing live streams is with this project with Songbringer. Since I'm doing these live streams, I don't feel like I'm doing it alone, even though I might be the only person actually doing all the code and music and art and everything. I'm not alone. I share it with you guys all the time, and not only that, but you guys share your ideas and stuff too. So that really it almost makes us co-creators in a sense. Oh. Okay, there. So I basically created a Git repository. Oh shoot, I forgot. Forgot this one bit of the command to remove any git ignore files because this can create a bad patch. There we go. Okay, so let's commit again. Wow, there's a lot of those. Shoot. I think I have to git add star again. I'm totally messing all this up, man. I keep doing everything wrong. Having to do it again. Not very good use of time, but. Oh well. Yep, so there. I removed all the git ignore files and adding everything. Just so what that does is it makes it so when I do check into git, it's actually committing everything and not ignoring stuff. There. Okay, now I'm ready to finally do this. Now I'm copying the patched version of cocos2d-x in. A star on that, yeah. And then I'm gonna create a diff. Oh, yeah. It's essential, the essential tool. Any kind of repository manager is essential. Not repository manager, but like version control in general is a super important tool for software. Okay, next step is to create a batch file finally. Git diff out to patch, and that should create like a freaking 5-line patch. This is going to be a very small patch for this one. There it is. Okay, that's fine. Okay, now I'm copying the patch back into my RapidGame folder. Okay. And I should have one change, and that's to change this cocos2d-x props. Well, no. What's all this? Oh yeah, that's the difference in the patch file. Okay, good. That's what the patch file should look like, and the diff on the patch file should look like. Okay, next step is to get this working, I think. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna upgrade package JSON. This is version 0.9.10 of RapidGame. And yep, this has changed. Well, I guess we can leave that as cocos2dx/js for now until people get used to the fact that there is no more cocos2djs. All right, yeah, we'll keep that all the same. Just upgrade the version. Okay, the URL. Okay, I'm gonna go check that out. Oh wow, interesting, that's cool. Good for them. Yeah, that just shows you how much better C++ performs in general than Java. Java's a pretty good language though. It's still a great thing you can develop games with, but that's one of the reasons why I prefer C++. Not only is it more portable, but it's also faster. Okay, so I'm grabbing the URL for cocos2d-x. They've got a mirror and stuff set up, I think. So I want to make sure that's... Let's see which one to use. By testing this URL out. Yeah, that's the URL they use ultimately. Okay. Okay. There. So now when RapidGame runs, it'll download this new version of cocos2d-x and apply the patch and then pre-build it all for you. So you never have to build it twice. It's just such a handy tool. Okay, so the next step in the upgrade process. Oh yeah, source downloaded. Cool. Okay, and the next thing, I'm not checking any of this in because it's actually not checked into this. Verify the pre-build command works. This is not going to work at all. But really what I should do is go and open up the project for this and get that working again. So the project for how RapidGame actually, what RapidGame does is it has, this is the RapidGame folder. It's pretty lightweight. All it has here in the source folder is a proj iOS Mac. Which is, this is what I need to edit right here. I need to go in and make sure this is still pre-building correctly. Or, well, it's of course it's not going to pre-build correctly because the whole paths for everything has changed. So what I'm going to need to do is get this working again. So, first thing, the libs is not even in there. JS binding is not even in there. Let's toss in the new lives. Should be here in this build folder. Now we got JS bindings. I think this might be here in the plugin folder. Or maybe they don't even have it anymore. Let's see. Find source cocos2d-x star.x code proj. Whoa, there's a lot of those. Wait a minute. Those aren't Xcode projects. Oh, I did that wrong. Name Xcode proj. Oh, there it is. It's in Cocos scripting JS bindings now. Which means I might not even need the plugins folder. But, oh yeah, I forgot, it doesn't matter. Yes, so cool. I like it when things don't matter. Scripting JS, but there it is. Already had this figured out, cool. Drag that in. Next I'm gonna close this and close that because I had the other project open, it was not allowing me to open up RapidGames version. So there we go. We've got lives again. We've got JS bindings again. And if this, let's change it to the Mac target. Let's manage these schemes because every time you go and drag in new projects in Xcode, it's gonna it automatically adds schemes for you. But I don't want those. This is my custom RapidGame project for building Cocos2d-x and the JS bindings at once. And we got iOS, Mac, and that's really all I want. So the Mac project, let's go edit the projects to see what's up. Make sure those are still building the right thing. So in build phases here, yeah, we need target dependencies. It lost everything when we dragged in these new projects. So let's get that working again. And this run script is also going to be very important to add. So both of these need, both of the Mac projects. And then this script might need to be changed to outputter source root dot 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 latest. I think that's right still. Let's see. Source cocos2d-x build. No. Source proj dot mac iOS mac. There. Yeah, so this is the sourcester. If I were to go ls dot 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 latest. Yeah, that'd be fine. Okay, and I want to change latest manually. So we got, let's remove latest. Wait, let's check what latest is first. Remove latest now, and then, yeah. I'm manually doing this. Normally the RapidGame command does this. It creates the directories and stuff for 0.9.10 and all that. So now I'm going to symlink from 0.9.10 to latest. Spelled it wrong. Today, man, today. RapidGame is really easy, man. It's really, really easy. If you check out the RapidGame page, yeah, I got a video there that kind of explains it. It's so easy. All you got to do is enter like one command and it downloads itself, compiles all of it itself. And then, yeah, I guess you're right. There is a learning curve because you do have to learn kind of how to use it in the sense. So there's a second command that actually, after you've built the libraries, you just go create a new game. And then you do have to kind of get used to the fact that it arranges things a certain way. But it arranges them a certain way so that you have like 2 megabyte game folders instead of 500 megabyte game folders. I do believe this is also going to need a cocos2d-x live folder. Yeah, I know, right? It does take a long time to learn tools, get used to things. Yeah. I make it sound like it's easy, but it really does take some time. I guess it's simple, but it is time consuming. So, yeah. Okay, there. Now we've got a live folder and everything, and let's see if it can actually build everything correctly. So what it would do is it should automatically build this correctly. Let's do this for the iOS project too. Okay, so there. We've got this set up. Now what I'm going to do is build and see if it actually creates the libraries. Cross your fingers. Oh, I know, everything takes time, right? Gosh, if it didn't take time, though, I was thinking about this the other day. It's like, I'm like, dude, I hate the fact that I come up with an idea for Songbringer for the game, maybe a series of ideas, and they take me an entire month just to get those few simple ideas. Something that I thought up in an hour takes me a month to do. And that's just always like trips me out. But then I realized if it didn't take time, then everyone would be able to create their ideas that lightning fast, and the world would be really weird. The world would be like everyone would have a Green Lantern ring and they could just like create an amusement park in seconds. It looks like it's building this correctly. That's good. While this builds, I'm going to go and start upgrading RapidGame itself. There's justice in the world. It's true, right? Okay, and I'm going to open it. No, I guess I'll just mate it. Yeah, mate RapidGame. Okay, so when RapidGame goes and pre-builds, it goes and it copies all of the source files. It copies all the header files into an organized folder that can be reused using symlinks. So the first thing I got to do is go and make sure it's copying all the header files correctly. Right? I don't know, man. Maybe. Okay, cool. We got rapid template. Oh, this is where it's creating the template files. Okay, I don't need to worry about that. I need to worry about this running the pre-build command first. And download, setup, pre-build, run pre-build. I think it's setup pre-build is the function I need to look at. Setup pre-build. Yeah. Here it is. Copying header files. All right, cool. See what I mean? This is why it's so awesome to have RapidGame, is you don't have to go and compile 800 source files just to get your game running. Oh my God. I remember those days. Okay, so we got cocos2d-x, yeah, that's the, and then include, yeah, JavaScript, those are all, we need all those, probably. So copy cocos2d-html5. This is in a totally different path now. So what's ver? Ver is command prefix version. Oh, that's the destination. So this is dest. Yeah, that's cool. But the source is frameworks. No. That's changed completely. So it's no longer source cocos2d.js. It's cocos2d-x. Right? Frameworks. Okay, this whole variable is now no longer the right name anymore. Let's call it source root. Cool. Now back to it. Let's do undo the last one. Redo the last. Oh man. TextMate works differently than Xcode. Oh, here it is. Okay, so we've got source root now, which is little is accurate now with the new path structure. So the next thing is to go. Yeah, that's right. Command prefix version ver. Yeah. Dest. Those are all good. Okay, so this is the first part. So I think it's just web. Source root web is the new HTML5 folder. Let's verify that. We got this web folder here. Yep. This is CC boot authors. This is the HTML5. They moved it into a new folder called web. So all that should be necessary here is just to change that line, and it should copy correctly now. So, give me one sec. I'll be right back. I'm going to get a drink of water. back at it. Let's see how this build's going. So I can build successfully. That is great news. Only one warning. Wait, no. What are these live tool messages? Oh, same member name. That should be fine. Let's see if it, okay, the proof is in the pudding. And that is to say, if it actually compiled the library file for 0910, cocos2d-x, lib, ooh, debug Mac, we got a Mac OS X. Yeah! Oh, 650 megs though. Wow, that's huge. I'm not sure if it actually, oh, okay, wait. That's because I actually just compiled it manually, but the script that actually runs RapidGame will actually strip this of it, any unnecessary stuff. No, I don't always use scenes. So, in Songbringer, I use the concept of a flux. It's just a transition from one thing to another. So I leave the game screen running, and then I just throw on another layer for the item menu, and the item menu slides in, and it just sits on top of the whole game. So the whole game is actually sitting there behind it, still running, but paused. Like, the game is paused, it's still running, and the new thing just slides in. So that's different. But I do use scenes in the traditional sense for a lot of other things. Like, for example, the main menu and other cutscenes and stuff. Okay, that's really good news. That built successfully built the library file. The next step is, yeah, let's close that. Let's finish getting all these header files to copy correctly. So we've got the web folder. The next thing we need to start copying is the headers. This is the destination, is the include folder. The source. Source is just source. Source root right now. Copy globbed. Okay, so this is copying everything within that. All the .h, .hpp, .message, .inline. Wait, did I do that right? I guess so. Wow, this is super new. This is cool because the cocos2d-x team has actually simplified things now. It's cool. So now it's removing unneeded stuff. Now it's copying the JavaScript bindings, all the .js files from those into the script folder. Let's find those, make sure they're in the right, where we think they should be, cocos2d-x. Ton of these. heck was I looking for in the first place? Bindings, script. There's like a script folder. Yeah, it's got to be in here in this binding folder. Scripting, JS bindings. But I didn't. Oh, I did this wrong again. Okay, it's not there. What? There's no more JS files anywhere? It's not true. I know there's JS files in here. There we go. Yeah, Cocos scripting, JS binding script. There it is. Okay, so that. Okay, we need a couple folders in here. Cocos scripting, JS bindings. Script. Cocos scripting JS binding script. Okay. All right. Next thing. Auto API. It looks like it's right there. Oh no! Here it is. Auto API. I think this is no longer necessary. Okay, now the Java files. These are necessary for building Android. They used to be in JS bindings, cocos2d-x, Cocos platform, Android, Java. Let's see where they are now. Plugins, of course, are going to have a bunch of them. Yeah, Cocos platform, Android, Java. Still the same path. Great. So we don't need that. All right, this might work. Kind of confused, as I'm not sure if this one's necessary. Oh, right. This is .mix.a's. Let's just comment this out for a second. Comment out all this Java stuff, and I'm just gonna copy. I'm gonna see if the C++ side works first. All right, so let's go clear. Now, RapidGame. Let's see. Make sure RapidGame is linked correctly. I don't think it is. It's using. Oh, it is. Okay. What? Why did it? Okay. First bug. How are these different? Lame. Oh, okay. I see what's wrong. It re-downloaded because the whole folder is changed. So one wise thing I should probably do is go through and find everything that has cocos2d-js and convert that path so it's correct. So that's what we're looking for now. Okay, so everything's moved here. Here's the new path for that. Okay, let's find all the solution files to got source cocos2d-x. All right, let's hope that works. Link windows. Oh man, all this has changed. That's it, that's all there is. Black Iron, what's up, man? What's up? Booga booga to you, too. How you been, man? Today I'm upgrading RapidGame. Nice, cool, man. Yeah, I've been good, dude. Songbringer's going so good, so great. I had a good vacation earlier this month, or last month, July. Yeah, Songbringer's going great, man. I've been working on all this cool stuff to have more interesting overworlds now. So I'll be getting back into that tomorrow. Today I'm just taking a break and doing Rapid Game. I just said take a break and do Rapid Game, which is one of the most non-break things ever. But anyways, I'm upgrading Rapid Game because there's a lot of cool new fixes in 3.7 of cocos2d-x, and I want other people to be able to use that and also be able to use it in Songbringer. So Cocos. I don't know where it puts all this stuff because I'm not on Windows right now. Yeah, I'm basically just upgrading my game engine. So, since I'm doing it all DIY style and it's all open source, it's a lot of work because I wrote this tool which makes life easier on a day-to-day basis for using my game engine, but whenever I have to upgrade it, my life is very difficult. This is like a long time. This could take like usually takes me about a day just to upgrade RapidGame. And that's a long time in game development to do something which should be so simple, you know what I mean? So one of the drawbacks of using cocos2d-x. All right, so I think we're ready to try RapidGame pre-build headers. No, don't download it again. Why did it download again? All right. Yeah, oh yeah, I haven't been working that long. I started really, really late today, yeah. So today, yeah, it's like 9:30. I probably started an hour and a half ago, something like that. Yeah, hour and a half. So yeah, it's been just definitely kind of a topsy-turvy day for me, just totally different order for everything. So that's why I'm doing this stream so late. I wanted to get at least one stream in today, even though I'm not working directly on Songbringer, I'm working indirectly on it. Thought I'd share it. So it keeps trying to download cocos2d-x. In fact, it probably already overwrote my... What's the problem here? Directory is command prefix source. That's correct. Destination is the dir plus cocos2d-x. That's correct. Downloaded file source downloaded. That's correct. Oh, it probably still. Oh. It probably erased my whole folder the first time it failed. So let's see if that's true. What happens is it erases everything and starts over. Yeah, this totally just erased everything. All right. Let's start over with that. And then we're going to apply the one patch manually, and hopefully it doesn't erase the folder. Whoa, it's weird. Okay. Let's copy a backup of this in case it messes up. Oh, man. Well, this particular upgrade for RapidGame is probably one of the worst ones ever because they changed everything. They changed the entire file folder structure for cocos2d-x because they now have integrated cocos2d-x and JS into the same package. It's actually a good move for the future, but this particular update for RapidGame is just a super bitch. So, let's see if this worked this time. So I'm going to clear that. Go back here, try and pre-build the headers again, and it should not attempt to re-download. Damn it. Why? Why? What's up, Neglected Peach? Hello, welcome to the stream. Sorry, I'm not really doing direct game development today. I'm upgrading my game engine, and I'm kind of frustrated. So, it's not you guys, it's me. I'm frustrated at this whole thing. So it's clear. What the hell is wrong with this? Okay, so yeah, so Neglected Peach, what I'm working on is I'm upgrading my game engine, which is cocos2d-x. And this particular update for cocos2d-x, they from 3.6 to 3.7, they changed a lot. So basically all the path structures, everything has just changed. So I've got to go and fix a lot of stuff. But that's what I'm working on today. Okay, these are freaking exactly the same. Are they not? What the heck? Why is it doing this? Oh, there's a V in there. Huh. Okay. Score one for the team. Is that true? Is there really a V in there? Apparently it gets added in the URL. Okay. Right? Let's see. Downloaded URL has a V. Wait. No, it's not true. There's no V. Oh man, maybe I actually left a V just in the freaking. Man. Simple little mistakes like this cause me so much pain and trouble. And it happens because my mind isn't fresh. Frustration leads to little bugs like this, which lead to more bugs. This is the lesson of every programmer. Every programmer should know this. You're best working when you're totally relaxed and having a good time. So I guess I'm kind of psyching myself out working on this difficult thing, and I've psyched myself out because in the past it's been difficult, and this has been one of the most difficult upgrades for RapidGame. So okay, let's try it again. This time it shouldn't re-download. Yes. All right. Cool. It's finally copying the header files. It's just gonna copy these header files. It should. Now I'm gonna, and then I'll go and I'll check everything that it copied. Right? Yeah. Yep. I know, right? Stress does that to us. It's like we gotta learn this. I gotta learn this lesson personally, which means I should probably turn off this stream and stop working on this right now, but. I do want to do a little bit more today. I did just fix that, so that's good. Okay. Pop the champagne. There, it's done. It's done. Okay, so here. What I need to check is this. This include folder. All right, cool. We've got cocos. We've got these subfolders. This might be good. Extensions, external, plugins. Let's compare it to the old 099 X include. We had bindings. Oh. Bindings, auto, manual. What were these? JSP cocos2d-x auto. I think that might be here and now in cocos scripting JS bindings auto. Yeah, they moved all this. Manual. Okay, that's fine. We don't need that bindings folder anyways. Java, okay, we didn't copy any Java files. Okay, cool. Looks like the script's copied correctly. All right, you know what? This is actually a pretty good job starting so far. Let's start pre-building. See if it works. If this works, man, I'm gonna jump for joy. It's probably not though. So I'm going to delete that existing one I tried to build there. I'm just going to build the Mac version. It's giving me a build log, which I can do a tail on if I want to check it out. Yeah, let's check it out. See what's going on. Tail that dash F build log, which will show me the end of the build log. Look at that. It is working. It's successfully generating object files. That's great. Sweet. Okay. Well, while it's doing this, I'll go and I'll finish up the stuff that built that copies the .java files. We got external. We have Spider Monkey here. Sweet. They really did a good job organizing cocos2d-x in this latest version. They really did put stuff in the better places. That it's no longer as disorganized as it used to be. So that's really good. For example, I used to have to do this special thing to put bindings in the right place. So I was copying from JS bindings into just the folder bindings, but that's moved completely. I'm just gonna leave it commented out for now in case I run into a bug trying to build it. This is JavaScript right here. Yeah. So what I'm working on here, actually, so I'm indirectly working on my video game Songbringer, which I use the cocos2d-x game engine. And so cocos2d-x is cool, but the one big issue I have with cocos2d-x is it takes forever to compile, right? So I wrote this tool called RapidGame. It's here at GitHub, Matt Weiss, RapidGame. And the basic gist of it is that it pre-builds all of cocos2d-x, so you never have to build it twice. And the other good thing about it is that it makes, instead of your game folders being like automatically 500 megabytes, they're only like 2 megabytes because it can symlink to the pre-built library folder. So there's more info on it here if you guys want to check it out. It's GitHub, Nat Weiss, RapidGame. So I'm working on upgrading RapidGame at this point, and it's one of the biggest, hardest upgrades for RapidGame that there's been in a long time because they changed where everything's at. So I'm just trying to make sure each step along this way I'm not breaking anything, because It's a delicate thing, you know. There's so many header files that go into making a game with cocos2d-x. I want to make sure they're all in the right place. So I'm just trying to verify this. So the destination here is external. Sorcerer.js. Yeah, okay. This should be fine too. But I'm going to leave those commented in or commented out for now. Oh, so what you're asking about is this Java? This is actually JavaScript because it's using Node.js. So if you ever heard of Node.js, it's pretty cool. Node.js is like a tool which allows you to run JavaScript apps, and you can kind of get the gist of what it is here on Node.js.org. Uh-huh. Oh. Yeah. Oh my god. Yep. We can all relate. Neglected Peach, Lith. What I'm doing right now. Yep. This is one of those moments. But one good news is this is working, so it's compiling correctly. That's pretty cool. And it looks like it did put all these header files in the right places. I just want to make sure. I think that JavaScript is working too. Right? Well. Okay, let's start working on this Java one too. So cocos2d-x uses Java files for its Android version. So cocos2d-x is a cross-platform game engine. It's really great that it can compile for so many different platforms. Like you can do Windows, Mac, Linux, iOS, Android, Windows Phone. So it uses Java files for the Android version. It's one of your best moments in college? Cool. That's awesome. Okay, so we had things in, yeah, we're copying to X Java. The destination starts with cocos2d-x, is that right? Oh, yeah, that's fine. Mm-hmm. Source, this is the important thing here. Yeah. Me too. I love learning. And that's served me very well in life. You know, I'm 35 years old now, and loving to learn has been one of my, has really, really aided me in so many different situations. So, but especially programming games. Because I love to learn, I love to explore how to make them, and that's always made me make better games. So that's pretty cool. What are we looking for here? Cocos platform Android Java. Let's see if we've got that. Keep this open. Cocos. Platform, Android, Java, we still have that. That's cool. I don't even need to change that one. That should be fine. In fact, if this is still the same, all of this should pretty much be the same. So source is now command prefix source, and we're copying everything from .mic, .a. That might work too. Long may you live. Thank you. source root. Oh, right. Yeah, this ought to be unnecessary now. Yeah, this might be okay. Let's see what happens when I do another pre-build headers. It's like we already got control C that one. So the real test after this all pre-builds is to go and try and start a new project with RapidGame, and if it actually can run that project, then it's golden. That's really all there is to it. The real challenge here was just changing all these paths to make sure they're correct. But then it's going to be also quite time consuming, because I'm going to have to go test this on Android, test it on Windows, test it on iOS. That's also kind of a bitch. But once it works, then I know it's way easy for me to take my video game Songbringer and put it on any platform, because I know that I've done all this baseline foundation work here with RapidGame. Cool, it built the header successfully again. So what we're looking at now is this Java folder. Yeah, cool, we got cocos2d-x. That's not right, shouldn't have the all these files here. Yeah, this is wrong. That's right. There's the Java files. But maybe this is right. Yeah, maybe this is right. I think that is right. Yeah, I guess that is the correct thing to do. Okay, we'll see if the MIC files made it correctly. Yep, we should have MIC files. We should also have lib files here in this folder. How big is this folder? 67 megs. It probably has some lab files in here somewhere. Like external. I bet you Chipmunk has some pre-built libraries. Yeah. ArmABI. Libchipmunk.a. Cool. Okay, this looks like it pre-built correctly. I'm going to go ahead and say that it did. 0910 is now correctly building its headers. And it looks like we're doing well on the actual build as well. Yeah. Oh, look at that. It succeeded with the very first build. Now it's working on the release version. Heck yeah. Woo, that's pretty cool. Okay, so I should be able to go and create a new project. Switch to the desktop. RapidGame gives me an example command. It's called heck yeah, that's great. RapidGame create cocos2d-x. So this is the command create. It creates a project for you. Heck yeah, com, my company, heck yeah. There we go. So what that did is it created this heck yeah folder on the desktop. Check out how small this is. 1.4 megabytes. That's because here inside the heck yeah folder, it uses a symlink. Heck yeah! It uses a symlink to link to the RapidGame pre-built libraries. So instead of you having to put gigabytes worth of data and libraries and stuff in every one of your games, all you need is this one symlink folder, really. So this puts up a project for you, and since everything relies on this single lib folder, all you need to do is make sure that lib folder, which links over here to 0910, if everything in here is correct, then it should be able to build this, everything in here. So, technically I should wait till that's done, but I'm gonna stop building that so I can go and build this other one here. So if this works, man. I'm gonna jump for joy. Heck yeah project. Project JSON, it's not found. It doesn't need one. Okay, this is good. All of its files are Cool. Let's see if it runs correctly. I need to make sure and remove that from the root project. But let's switch to the Mac version, and we're gonna just run. It should run and build really fast. And if it works, it'll just run this test application really quick. And yeah, that's when I'm gonna jump for joy if this works. Do I have some joy I can actually jump for? Something joyful in this room? Not really. Oh, one error, come on, man. Oh, just because of the project JSON file? Come on, we don't need it. All right, anyways, this is an easy fix, quick fix. Oh, really? Thanks, Ferrologix. I'll switch it back. Why is that? Why do you think why is it better having it in the bottom right corner? This is an easy fix though. That's cool. All I gotta do, I'm gonna manually edit templates, cocos2d-x, to scene, projects, to scene, project.pbxproj. Jump for the painting? Oh, jump for the painting. Oh, cool. Okay. I wish I could put the painting on the ceiling really quick, but. Okay, so let's look for. Project.json. You know what? I'm embarrassed, but I'm gonna use nano for this. No, I know this command. I'm still learning Vim. What's the command? It's dd, right? Dd deletes the same line. Yeah, nice. Okay, so file names. Yeah, what was being covered up there? Yeah, all right, cool. All right, good. I'll keep it there in the bottom right. Oh, you're Gladiar. Oh, okay, all right. What's up, Gladiar? DD. DD? 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 You can tell I like the DD command. All right. So let's write that out. Let's see if we can open, let's make sure the project still opens. Well, actually, let's just delete the heck yeah. Let's create a new version of heck yeah. There we go, open it up. Heck yeah. Heck yeah, it works. We'll see if it can build now though. Oh, I don't want the iOS version. That one, I haven't built the libraries for yet. I want the Mac version. Yes! Okay, come on. Oh, it crashed! You suck! I totally heard it start its whole like sound effect and everything. Good thing it didn't play its sound effect, because man, it was way too loud for the stream. Navmesh agent crashed. Step physics scene crash? What is wrong with this? Pre-update? This is where the bitch part comes about when cocos2d-x gets upgraded. So I have no clue why this is broken now. But let's start with a clean build, I guess. At least it built. That was pretty cool. That means that all the header files are in the right place, and the libraries did get built correctly. So that part is pretty good. Let's see. With the clean build, let's see if it can build or in run. Well, I guess what I could do is start commenting out code until it works. That's usually one strategy to get things working. Yeah, it just starts playing its sound effect and then dies. So let's start with the game. Oh no, I don't need that. It starts with the menu scene. Let's do I'm going to get rid of everything except for the background. See if that makes it work. Nope, it can't even do that. Damn. This is a crazy bug because I have no clue. I don't know. I mean, it's getting to here. It appears that it's getting to this nav mesh update function, and this nav mesh update is crashing for God knows why. Because I'm not even using nav meshes. I guess I'm indirectly using scene, step physics, and navigation. Oh man. Okay, you know what? Here's a crazy thing to try. I'm gonna try and see if Songbringer could work. For some reason it's weird, but Songbringer like works sometimes when other simple projects don't. So I'm gonna switch to my Songbringer directory, and I'm just gonna remove its lib for all, because I use RapidGame for Songbringer. See, I got a lib sim link there. I'm gonna remove my lib sim link. Create one manually with this new version of RapidGame. And then let's just see if Songbringer can build correctly. Clean. Start from scratch. Rebuild. If this doesn't work, I'm probably gonna have to take a break here, because I got frustrated a long time ago with this project, so this whole RapidGame upgrade process. So yeah, I'll definitely need to take a break if this doesn't work. All right, we no longer have the set uniform float array. That's okay. I can comment that out for now. If this does work, I'm not gonna have shaders working. Hello, C Cirky Porco Lot 90. What are you, man? Trying to fish? trying to, what are you doing, man? Are you a real person? Are you a bot? Who are you? Blocking. How do I block him? I thought I was here. There. I'm gonna give him one chance. See, sir, K-man, if you talk within the next 30 seconds and tell me you're a human, that's cool. If not, I'm gonna ban you. Okay, I'm just gonna ban you because I trust Lith. You're getting banned, man. Sorry. All right. Where are we at? Okay, I commented that out. Yeah, even this crashes. Same thing, nav mesh pre-update. That's where it's crashing. Oh, you had it on your stream too? Yeah. Thanks, Lith. Use alien? Well, okay, damn it. Songbreaker doesn't work. The test project for RapidGame doesn't work. It's crashing in this thing called nav mesh. Yeah, what are you streaming, by the way? Okay, so all right, I'm gonna give this 5 more minutes. I'm gonna try to fix it using this. This non-rapid game version. So I'm gonna link to rapid game. It's cocos2d-x source folder. Now I'm gonna update Songbringer's project.pbx proj. Search for cocos2d.js. Nice, man. What kind of games do you stream? Cheating. I'm using Nano. Look at, gosh, I just love Nano. Forgot how much I love Nano. RPGs and RTSs. Cool, man. Some of my favorites, too. Always loved. Oh, dude, I just. I forgot how to use Nano. What the heck is the search command? Oh, there it is. Dude, I've been using Vim for a long time now. So long enough to forget how to use Nano. No, I can't do it this way. I need to search. Screw Oh, yeah. I had that same fear with Songbringer. I was like, man, somebody gonna steal my idea. But I figured that ideas are kind of like seeds. The second they get in someone else's hands, they grow into a totally different kind of tree, which might not be all entirely accurate all the time, but you got to take risks sometimes. So, cocos2d lives. Where the heck did it put this? Dude, I'm definitely running out of steam now. My eyes are starting to get cross-eyed. I think it's in build. Yeah, cocos2d underscore lives dot xcode. Yeah, okay, this is fine. If I just go delete all that. I don't need this JS bindings. DD. Yes, DD, my favorite. I don't need this script folder either. DD. Sweet. Exactly. Yeah, that's a good way to think of it. Yeah. That's kind of how I guess what I'm doing with Songbringer. I guess someone could try and steal my exact same game and do exactly what I'm doing. But I'm always going to be a step ahead because I'm the only person that really knows what the heck I'm going to do next, anyways. So I guess I was worried about that too, Farologix, a long time ago. That was one of my biggest fears actually before I started live streaming. But yeah. I actually had to work it out. I had to work it out in my mind and decide that I wasn't afraid of that. That was a tough decision. Okay, you know what? I should learn how to do. Dang, dude, that's right. Somebody, I remember that. That sucks, man. So lame. So lame, right? That's such a. It's like such an important thing to us, programmers. Hey, what's up, DJ? Hey, thanks, man. It's cool. Welcome to the stream. Thanks for saying hi. Thanks for saying the code looks impressive. That's cool. But one day, I'm sure if you pay enough attention, you and start making your own games, your code will be impressive too. At a train stop. Damn. Damn. Yeah, this is. I'm not gonna do this. Yeah, me too. I use Git, and I have my own server, so I back everything up many times per day to my to that. Yo, professional novice, what's up? Late night foo, for example. Yep, totally, man. How late is it now? 10:30? Dang, I've been streaming for a while. Cool, man. Good for you. Good for you. Web development. I've done a lot of that, too. Cool. Oh, good, good. I'm glad your stuff is on GitHub and Dropbox. That's cool. Okay, so I should just be able to open up the Songbringer project again. And then toy with the non-rapid version. It's taking so long. It looks like I might have broken it. Yeah. I crashed Xcode trying to open the project. It probably. All right, man. What up? Cool, man. Well, have a good sleep. I'm about to go to sleep soon, too. I use C++, but you're seeing me do some totally different stuff than I normally do. And yes, I this right here was JavaScript. This is what I was using. I'm upgrading RapidGame, which is a tool for pre-building cocos2d-x, and I wrote it in node.js, so that's why it is JavaScript, but my game is actually in C++. Yeah, I really messed that up. Okay, so I gotta go back. What did I change? This, I just deleted these lines. Looks like I tried to change another line. There you go, yes. Okay, I'm gonna check that back out. Get the old version. Projects. Songbringer, project, PBX proj. So now I should be able to reopen it. The dream. Dreams do come true. Okay, so I'm gonna switch to the Mac debug. Oh man, I'm just gonna mate it. Mate projects. There you go, nice. Wow, I don't even need these anymore. Oh yeah, it's a good question. Where to study some game development? What I recommend doing is first you want to find a game engine you want to use. So I would play around with four or five game engines first thing, right? So go check out Game Maker, but you also really want to maybe more Unity. Like Unity and Unreal are really good engines to try out. And you might want to try cocos2d-x if you like, open source engines. And then once you've played with all those game engines, then go and pick one you like, right? That will give you the feeling of, okay, I really like this game engine. Then just do some tutorials. That's how I would learn to make a game today. If I were starting over learning game development, I would first pick an engine. I would then just do tutorials on it. And the goal for that is to get used to the game engine, because really getting used to your tools is like half the process right there. You get just if you know a language, that's great, but you still got to get used to the tools, and that could take 6 months, sometimes 3 months maybe, just to get used to a game engine enough that you could write a game with it. Yeah, SFML, that's another one too. Yeah. Cool. Yeah. Right, this should be okay. Don't crash. Oh, you're crashing again. Damn it. Yes, totally. Yeah. Visual Studio is a great one to do. Totally. That's one of the top ones I would use personally for making games. I use Xcode because I really like Mac better, but Visual Studio is what I use to compile Songbringer on Windows. So yeah, I would highly recommend it. It's been around for, decades, so it's not really going anywhere. It's still a very popular one to use, so that's why it's a good one to learn, in the sense that you learn it now, and you're probably still going to be using it 10 years from now. So, and yeah, if you're predominantly a Windows developer, I would stick with Visual Studio for sure. I've heard of there's new ones now. There's App Code or something like that. There's a couple other ones from there's ones from JetBrains, and there's a new one that Microsoft has. But I would still stick with Visual Studio myself, because once you learn it, you don't need to really learn anything else. So. Uh, Yeah, I'm getting really close to my limit for how much I can do today, but let me try one more time. See if I can get this whole start over with the Songbringer project. Open it up and just manually do it by hand, upgrading to use this new cocos2d-x folder. Switching to the Mac debug non-rapid version. Okay, there. So that time it didn't crash because I did it inside Xcode. But now I'd still need to go. Oops. Still need to. So I just want to go dot dot slash rapid cocos2d-x. Yeah, and that's the point he brings up here about isometric games is cocos2d-x is pretty good for that. They've got a cool tiled editor and everything's already kind of set up for isometric. I think this is good. Okay, so I'm gonna go back to Xcode, Songbringer. Cool. It opened the project. That's like that was important. And it should, if I look at where this file is located, it should give me the path. Dot dot cocos2d-x. Cool. Okay, there's that. That's good. What's that? We don't need that. We don't need project.json. Move that to the trash. Okay. Songbringer. The regular Mac project. Go to the paths. And yeah, I should be able to manually edit all these now. Let me close that, close this, reopen this. And everywhere that it's got. Okay, this should work, and now it's going to save me a lot of time. I think you have to pay for it if you're releasing games that are pro with it or something like that. I guess like it's cheaper though than it used to be. Right, cool, it opened. This is a good start. All these header paths should now be yes, dot dot cocos2d-x. Right. So if I start building, it's definitely going to need this target dependency. It's not doing it at all. Yeah, it's giving me like 100 errors because I didn't even put live cocos2d in there. That's pretty important. iOS version is iOS. These are the this is where I manually can compile cocos2dx. So what that should allow me to do is figure out why the heck this whole mesh thing is crashing. It's like the thing with cocos2dx is like, why is this new thing they created called something nav mesh or something like that is crashing? I'm not even wanting to use it, and it's crashing. But this should help point out why. Might be something's missing from my setup code. Like maybe I need to use nav meshes off or something like that, or I don't know. Maybe it could be the RapidGame just compiled wrong somehow. It missed some library file or switched some object file out incorrectly. I guess I'm gonna have to call it a day here pretty soon. I just wanna see if this can actually provide any clues as to what's going wrong. So we just have to kind of wait for it to build cocos2d-x again. It's building kind of slow because whenever I have Open Broadcaster running, it uses up enough CPU that it slows down my builds. So that's what's going on here. That's why it's taking so long. Man, it's like waiting for paint to dry. Really? Check it out. Thanks, Fadiar. Wow. Cool. I'll have to give this a try. Is it does it cost anything? $6.99. Wish I could try it before I buy it. Didn't know I needed it. Cool. I'll give this a save. Consider for later. Thank you, Gladiar, Farologics. I'm only halfway done. Oh, let's watch the Sanic video. There's this one I really love. Oh, no, it's okay. It's all right. Yeah. I don't want to. I want to respect the authors of that program and like get it if I if I'm committed to getting it, I'll just get it. Thanks, though. Where's the 1 minute Sanic? What's up, Game Vivo? Hey man, it's been a minute. Cool, good, good to know. Here it is, gotta go faster. This one's great. Yes, of course you can. Yes, I think you can. What do we got? 600 of 800 files? I love this one. Fast. Two times fast. Fast and furious. 420 fasts. Faster than wind. Good fast. Almost super fast. Flame on. Nearly super fast. Super fast. Really super fast. Over 9,000. Too fast for me. Actual too fast. Ah! Follow your dreams. Fast. Sanic. It's my favorite one. I don't know. Yeah, that's a good question. What's different about yours? Whoa. We're getting there. 700 of 800. Okay. Almost there. 750 of 800. I'm about to fall asleep. So why is it better? Why is it safer? Maybe you can focus on those things. Still fail? So pretty much everything failed. Failed the link. Should be a warning at the beginning of all this to kind of give me a clue. No? Oh, I know what it is. Mac, link. I need not, it needs not only the target dependency, but it needs to link with the library. So I need to include lab cocos2d Mac in this one, in the iOS version. Lab cocos2d iOS. Back to Mac. And now build. All right. Yes, it built. Okay. If it's easy, how come you guys don't do it? It's not easy, man. No one said it was. Okay, here we go. We're getting a. It took me a long time to get to this point, but all I did that for was to get it to crash and actually break so I can see what the hell is going wrong that cocos2d-x would just crash. And this is confirming not only that it is crashing here in Nav Mesh Agent pre-update, but it's also confirming that RapidGame, there's no problem with it, how it compiled RapidGame. It's actually somehow crashing here in cocos2d's Nav Mesh pre-update. Yeah, you're bringing up some really good points here, Gladiar, to Game Vivo. I know it's hard to debug this, but I'm hot on the trail now. Yes, that's a really good point there. I like bunnies. Why did Google Plus fail? Take a look at how why they failed and see if you can do it better. Okay, so the problem is that this Nav Mesh agent, it's this pointer is wrong because there's no other way that it's a member variable of it would be just that messed up. So crash and Nav Mesh update. Dude, cocos2d-x. This is where I crash Nav Mesh update. No details, nothing from. Oh, man, well, I guess the next thing I would do is go try and run the cocos2d-x 3.7 test projects and see if they're crashing. And if they're not crashing, try and figure out why they're not crashing. So this is good. This is really good to know that it's not RapidGame's fault. So I guess I can check in my changes to RapidGame so far. What's up, fat guy? Right, X Pixel. Welcome to the stream, X Pixel. Oh, it's not NavMesh. It's the NavMesh agent. So apparently this NavMesh, which I have no clue what that is, must be a new thing in 3.7. Yeah, I'm guaranteed it is. This must be a 3D thing because they added so much new 3D stuff to a 2D game engine, I should add. Thanks, fat guy. Yeah, it's throwing an error here. The error is that it's executing bad access. What that means is that this pointer here, this to NavMesh agent, is bad. See, it's trying to access its member variable called state. This member variable, accessing it because it's this pointer is just wrong for some reason. Trying to access its state is just wrong, so it's crashing. So that's the error that's going on. And that's where I'm like, how the hell do I fix this? I have no idea. I have no idea because, like, what the heck is a nav mesh? I've never heard of it so far in any of my cocos2d-x endeavors. So, you know, it's here. It's using it here in this. Oh, here. If CC use nav mesh, here's a clue. Maybe I should just turn that off. Yeah, what I'll do is I'll turn that off. Okay, let's turn it off. CC use nav mesh. That's gonna be here in, where does it define that? There it is, CC config. Use 3D navigation API, 0, don't do that. All right. So this is gonna freaking cause me to recompile 800 source files. This is exactly why I built RapidGame. Because every time you have to freaking change one little thing in cocos2d-x, you have to recompile 800 source files. I'm not even gonna do this right now. It's gonna take too long. I'm freaking tired and frustrated, so I'm gonna just call it quits for tonight. But the good news is I did update RapidGame and changed a lot to get it to work with a new version of cocos2d-x. And it wasn't RapidGame's fault that cocos2d-x is broken because I built it manually without RapidGame and it still was broken. Oh, right. Thank you, DX Rasm. Thank you. Yes, you're right. I did see that in their update. They were talking about that. That's right. So for some reason, this is crashing, and I have no idea why. I know, right? This is exactly why I built RapidGame. RapidGame basically just pre-builds cocos2d-x. So you build it once, you never have to build it again. So it looks like I may have to do this define. I might have to actually patch cocos2d-x's ccconfig.h and use this and turn off using navmesh. Cuz I don't know why it's broken. I'm not sure if I can fix that. And I bet you anything cocos2d-x team is already working on fixing that. I know, yeah. Nice. You're really knowledgeable on this subject. Okay, it is building a little faster this time. I guess I'll just let it run. and we can see if it works. I mean, if this works, then that means that I just pretty much am gonna do this in the late in the newest version of RapidGame. I'm pretty much gonna have to turn that off because I don't know how to fix it. Man, I'm getting hungry. I really do gotta stop doing this. I gotta go get some dinner and stuff, but I just wanna see this work. Cause that'll put my soul at ease. GameVivo, one thought I have for you is that, to me, Facebook sucks because of their algorithm. So many people try and game the algorithm behind Facebook. I love social networks like Twitter, where if I follow someone, I get all of their updates. It's not like Facebook, where I get some of their updates, depending on Facebook's incredibly enigmatic algorithm or whatever that chooses for me what I want to see. I hate that about Facebook. If I were you, GameVivo, I would make something simple like Twitter, where if you follow somebody, you get all their updates. So it's clear, it's genuine. I want to know when my friends do cool stuff. I don't want Facebook to sort through all of these posts for me. I want to see real time, right when my friends update stuff. I want to see what they're doing. But Facebook has this stupid algorithm that hides posts for me that are newer, but shows me posts that are more popular. It's essentially a popularity contest. That's what I hate about Facebook. That's why I don't really like to use it that much. So if I were you, I would focus on that first, but that's just me in my opinion. Ah, wow. Yes, right? Yeah, if it does work, you feel like the smartest human alive? For sure. I know, yeah, and your news is from 3 days ago. It's so stupid, right? Dude. I just told you my opinion, man, on how you could do that. It's true. I agree with XPixel here. This is a very difficult task. I do believe, because I'm an idealist, I do believe that anyone could do it. And that's why I say GameVivo, I think you could do it if you really, really wanted to and it was your main passion in life. I bet you could create a social network that would succeed. But it would have to be different, you know what I mean? A lot of these people here in the stream are trying to tell you that. Basically, you can't just do what Facebook did and try and succeed because they already did that, and they're already doing that. Yeah, totally. Twitter's awesome. I would look to Twitter as a good example of an awesome social media network. All right, okay, I've recompiled with CCU's nav mesh 0, and let's see if this works. Man, this is kind of giving me a headache, this whole stressful rapid game upgrade process. Man, I definitely need to take a break soon. But it's almost there. It's almost there. Hey, what's up, Sid? Hello, welcome to the stream, man. Let's see, cross your fingers. Oh, their physics 3D component crashed too. Dude, I swear, this makes me want to just go yell at people, yell at the cocos2d-x team. I know they did good stuff. I know this is a good update in general, but seriously, it is crashing like crazy. Now it's the physics 3D component, which also I'm not using. So I guess I would have to turn off physics 3D. Step simulate, step. Yeah, so I would want to turn off CC use 3D physics, which I'm just not going to do right now. I'm too tired to try this again. I'm going to have to let this sit for a second. All right. Well, there you have it. That's it for today's video. Today's stream. You're alive still? That's awesome. Yes. Yes. It's not broken. It's just isn't as fixed as it should be. I love that, DJ. Thank you, man. Thank you. All right. Good night. Yeah, I'm logging out too. So, yeah, thanks for watching, everybody. I hope this maybe taught you guys something, was helpful to you guys. I'm going to put this video on YouTube as well as all my other videos. So if anybody's interested in RapidGame, you can kind of see what this is like to update it and stuff. So yeah, catch you all later. I'll be back tomorrow. I'm usually around 4 p.m. Pacific time. Today was a total exception. So yeah, right. Thanks, fat guy. Thank you. Yes. All right. Take it easy, you guys. Cheers.